Here we are at the magical land of Universal Studios Hollywood. First time ever. It's going to be pretty fun. I can't wait.
Voodoo donuts. Big voodoo donut doll outside with a pretzel stuck in. That's funny. Check it out. It's Mr. and Mrs. N. Stein. And like always, we'll probably eat in the Hard Rock Cafe. Check it out. It's Christmas Kong. It's the globe. Big Universal Globe. Look, they've laid out the red carpet for us as we're walking in. I wonder who that is. Who are these guys? Hey, there's an old car.
They chase them out of the box.
You forgot your box.
And they went, that's fine. How would you box it up? Your wig's in the box.
How you doing? What a day you've got. It's Happy New Year, everybody.
Happy New Year. It's me, Stella Kowalski, my husband Stanley over here.
Yo.
We live here on the York streets.
The greatest neighborhood around this area.
It's in this general area, it's the best neighborhood.
I mean, some of the kids in this neighborhood have pigtails, some of them don't.
Some of them wear a robe, some of them don't.
You know what I mean? Some of them wear a necktie, some of them don't.
Some of them wear a pink bow, some of them don't.
Some of the kids in this neighborhood have mermaids on their t-shirts. And then some of them don't.
Okay. Some people wear pink shoes. Some people don't wear
shoes. Some people wear skirts and other people wear skirts. Generally, the kids in this neighborhood wear skirts.
That's true.
That is the one thing that we all have in common.
Yeah, that's true.
I'm wearing one right now.
What? It's a kilt.
Yeah.
Husband's Scotch.
My cousin gave it to me. It went to Scotland.
It was a whole thing.
They wanted to do that. All right, Dad, you have your map out, so just ask me where you want to go because it'll be faster.
Where are you headed, Dad?
Where do you want to go?
Where are you going? Oh, you're almost there!
You're almost there.
It's right next door, this way!
Did you just get here?
Well, she's so decked out, I would have thought you'd been here 20 times already.
That's right. And what's your name again, sweetheart? Jessica?
Not telling.
We won't need to know.
Wait, what is it? Yeah, just yell it. Yeah,
just go ahead and yell it. There's a helicopter. You got it nice and loud.
Yeah, just yell it. What is it? Jelly. You want some jelly? Well, I got some strawberry preserves, I think.
Is that the same? What's the difference between jam and jelly? Do you know?
I'm not sure. I don't know either.
What is your name, though? Oh, it goes in your belly, the jelly.
Oh, okay.
Here's the Walking Dead haunted house. It's not open yet, but we'll be checking this out later for sure. First ride, Minion Mayhem. Look, it's a Minion. Which one's that, babe?
For real, I have no idea.
Justin McCree. That's
right. But remember, do not put on the goggles until you are told to do so. This will happen. I'm not saying this will happen, just that it could happen. If it did, it'll be fine. Mark for me! I usually take this time to interview new recruits one at a time, but I'm working on something really big today, so I'm going to have to do this kind of quick. Hello, I'm Gru. What's your name? Where are you from? Well, that might be impressive. What's your first question? And thank you. Anywho, one moment. Mm-hmm. This is good. But tell Nefario, add more dynamite. I want a bigger boom. You didn't hear that. Anyway, yes, you will be turned into minions. Months ago, my chief scientist, Dr. Nefario, created a device that could turn everyday boring civilians like you into minions. At first, there were a few minor snags. I'm packing your store at the mail. We are going to be minions or farts.
Minions or farts?
Ignore them.
Not now.
Okay.
Don't be scared, girl.
He's just a baby.
shoot you with a fart gun.
Oh, no.
Hey, it smells like banana.
Banana?
Trying to figure it out.
What's this?
pretty positive that these things are what they had on the hedge maze for the Shining maze. And they're just reusing them for Christmas hiding stuff. Alright, so I wasn't allowed to record inside the actual haunt, but I recorded right up to like the front doors where we walked in. It was kind of short. I mean, it was actually really short. There's only like, I don't know, maybe eight rooms in there, but they're all really detailed. A lot, pretty much like one area from each season of the show. So, yeah, it was cool. I mean, the props were pretty cool. There was a few actors in there, one or two in each area. So it was cool. Kind of a classic Halloween Horror Nights style haunt. All their scares are jump scares with audio and lighting cues on an actor activated trigger. So anyway, we're walking now to some new stuff, see what else has happened in this park. We're stopping off and eating a Krusty Burger. Check out this view. Pretty sweet, huh? Look over there, it's Hogwarts. So we're currently in line for the studio tour, and there's a lot of fucking people in this line. A whole lot of people.
That movie sucked.
Studios, you can see it. Hand just a little bit.
Jacob,
move your head. There's the Warner Brothers Water Tower, kind of famous. Let's see if I can zoom in. Is that saying that this was the studio?
That's Burbank, California.
And I'll show you how far away we are. About that far away.
Our movie posters represented some of the greatest films of all time. In fact, we've been making movies for over 100 years. Carl Lemley, our founder, opened Universal Studios Hollywood March 15, 1915. And there he is, an opening day. And the man had a dream to not only make great movies, but to show you how great movies are made. The very first movie made here at Universal is this film right here. It's now considered a classic. There's Jim Carrey from Bruce Almighty running down the stairs on your right-hand side. That's called Brownstone Street. Maybe you believe we were in Buffalo, New York.
B-E-A-U.
And then on your left-hand side is Baltimore and Hairspray Live. Then on your left-hand side, guys, the City Hall building was the clock tower and the greatest movie ever made, Back to the Future. Back to the Future, congratulations. Life's downhill from now, trust me. This is the greatest movie ever made. That's not up for debate. You can try to debate me, but she'll lose because I have a microphone. Now, the building does look
right there.
when you kids might be forced to read this book at school, don't waste your time. Watch the movie. Gertie Bennett? Are you an overachiever? Thanks for going to tell me you're in Harry Potter. What? Kids doing? You don't need books. They make movies out of everything. You only need Facebook. Trust me, I'm older than you, which means I'm smarter. Take a look down on your left, see a painted mural. It looks pretty fake to the naked eye. It'll look absolutely real through the lens of the camera. These buildings are about 50 feet tall, but through the lens of a camera, they're gonna look bigger and larger than they really are. That's called forced perspective. Take a look on your left, the Lear Theater. You can see that in Spider-Man 2 with Tobey Maguire and Kirsten Dunst. This area was San Francisco and Dirty Harry. It was London and Austin Powers. And Transformers was also filmed here, which is 8 feet tall. It's pretty massive. They are the largest. We need to protect ourselves from King Kong. Any suggestions?
Godzilla.
3D glasses? All right, let's do that. I was going to say turn around. That's better. All right, guys, get ready. We're about to go into Small World. Here's Director Peter Jackson.
See, original King Kong was amazing watching the movies. I saw that movie on TV when I was about 8 years old. I like films that just take you away from your real life and sweep you up on adventure. Kong literally does that. I mean, you're on board the ship, you're sailing to a lost island, you're encountering monsters and creatures from, you know, prehistoric times. So I was thrilled when Universal invited me back to Skull Island, and it's great to have you along for the ride. Now, we have created this 3D immersive experience, so you're going to have your glasses ready. Don't put them on yet, but just have them in your hand because we're about to return to Skull Island.
You guys can put on your 3D glasses, it's okay. We're about to enter Skull Island, and I want to remind everyone to remain seated, keeping your arms nice inside the shrimp, and
what's going on in this bitch? Ooh. And water spray.
To the future. Kids, check out the cars your parents used to drive when they were your age, the Flintstones. And Universal's largest film franchise to date is Fast and the Furious. You might have noticed a Jeep from Jurassic World. By the way, there's a great cameo in Jurassic World you might have missed. When the pterodactyls are attacking, running to what's that were used in The Lost World, the sequel to Jurassic Park. On your left hand side, the mobile lab that's also on your monitor. Shoved over the edge of a cliff by an angry dinosaur.
motherfucker.
I knew those dinosaurs were gonna spit on you, but I'll be honest, you guys deserved it. By the way, I love the music to Jurassic Park. It's composed by John Williams. John Williams did the music to movies like Jaws, E.T., Indiana Jones, Superman. Now they made more of
these
them.
Trees are all like a spray foam
the
with
70s, right?
Added,
70s?
Added moss and sticks and stuff. You can see that right up on them.
8 plus 1?
Kind of tall.
Cool. Get out more. Now we're going to check a weather forecast. From today's show, here's America's favorite weatherman, Paul Roper.
This forecast for the Universal Backlot. It's going to be sunny and dry in Six Points, Texas. Cool and cloudy in Little Europe. Expect snow and sleet on New York Street. And we've got a high chance of fog and precipitation for Skull Island, Amity Island, and Isla Nublar. That's your forecast for today. Now here's a look at what's going on.
Looks like we've got some rain going on out there. I'm going to let you in on a Hollywood secret. The rain you're looking at is not real. Yeah, that's called a sprinkler. Now two things happen out here in Los Angeles when it rains. One, we forget how to drive. And two, you guys agree with me? And two, we get flash floods. Do you hear that noise? No? Cool. Thousands of gallons of water released from a tank up the hill. Take a look at this. This is from Big Fat Liar. Right
you can't outrun the wolf, kid!
Yeah, we'll see about that.
I love it!
Filmed right here in Old Mexico, as well as comedies like Nacho Libre and Three Amigos, The Last Man on Earth on Fox with Will Forte, HBO's Westworld. Speaking of the West, we're going into the Old West. This is where Universal got its start making Westerns right in this area. Back in the 1920s, we were making about 100 Westerns a year. Speaking of, let's take a look at one of these classic Mexican standoffs.
Six Points, one of the oldest sets on the Universal Lot.
I hear this is where John Wayne and Jimmy Stewart shot a few of their westerns.
That's right. That's where I aim to shoot you.
Looks like we got ourselves a Mexican standoff. Lucky shot.
Now what say you mount up and get out of town while the getting good?
All right. Well, I'll see you again, pal.
Or you can count on me, pal.
This is the beginning of a beautiful friendship.
We just have to talk it out, that's all.
We are about the midway point of our tour. As a reminder, the cord above your head is there for any bus assistance. Now, when I was a kid, I loved westerns. I grew up watching these. And my favorite scenes were like on NBC with Ted Danson and Kristen Bell.
You, Eleanor Schultz. Right there. This location, the afterlife, I have never ever seen this.
You're in a good place.
I'm not supposed to be here. I can't risk going to the bad place.
Maybe it's not all that bad.
Come here. How can I help you?
What is the bad place like?
Thank you.
you noticed, but the tombstone there, it read Orlok.
Thanks for your patience. We're going inside a soundstage right now. This is where a scene from the TV show Bones was filmed. Take a look at that scene. Shark, I believe he's still on the water. Oh, there he is, swimming around. Who's he swimming towards? And I was going right towards Officer George. George, get out of the water!
Right towards the Gatorade.
Oh, he's eating him alive! That's disgusting. Jaws 40 minutes into the film. You can also see it on the monitor. That's the best little warehouse in Texas. Looks like they misspelled warehouse. Found it on your left with Scary Lane, which was home to Desperate Housewives for 8 seasons on ABC.
Money's the word here, and I'm pushing. It's a good name.
On your left, Dominic Toretto's Dodge Charger, Fast and the Furious. Hanging out front is The Rock.
It was all the fantasy world that Dr. Seuss became a reality.
And there's the sets, guys. This is one of the largest productions that take place on our back lot. They used 11 of our sound stages. 2 of those sound stages were used for makeup to apply to all of the actors. And they had a cinematic makeup chef for hours. Yeah, psycho. Take a look at Captain All right, guys, we're safe. Stay quiet. We're going to be fine. Maybe he won't notice 170 people watching him commit murder in broad daylight. So far, so good. Now, if he spots us, do me a favor. Don't wave at Norman Bates. Don't try to call him over here. What are you doing? I said don't wave. Stop doing that. He's... Oh, no, he doesn't like that. He's got a knife, everybody. He's spotted somebody in car 4. Watch out, guys. We narrowly escaped at 3 miles an hour. Still down there. The most colossal set we've ever built, the amazing plane crash scene from War of the Worlds. Directed by Steven Spielberg, starring Tom Cruise and Dakota Fanning. Take a look.
Site is perfect example of a set that is all designed around vision.
He's again to sit down and talk about the world. Well, that thought, what if the 747 goes down right in a big neighborhood? Because it's just something you don't see.
You're doing good. Listen to me. Listen to me. Close your eyes, okay? Now close. Robbie, get in. Get in.
That is a real plane. This was specifically for the film. Up with water, brought in a plane, had a bunch of actors there. That's a practical set because it was done on camera. The background is CGI, computer. Where all the Fast and the Furious stunts come to life. I'm gonna bring up Agent Vilka for a demonstration.
Operation. My name is Special Agent Luke Carlton of the U.S. Diplomatic Security Service. And as of 16.9 seconds ago, I'm the man in charge.
The hell you are?
Let me clue you in on two.
So that was the tram ride. Now we're off and into Harry Potter Land, Hogsmeade. And we've got a bunch of drinks. So I got a pumpkin juice, little pumpkin lid thing. And then we got all kinds of butterbeer. Cold one and a hot one.
No. A frozen one.
Oh, frozen one.
And a hot one. So, I'm gonna go get a cold one here in a minute.
So they have frozen and cold and hot. So this is frozen, so it's like icy. It's kind of like a slushy, right?
Yeah.
And then
like
hot, which I like, but right now it's too hot. And yeah, these are all good. So, pro tip, if you come here and you want any of these drinks, and I'm pretty sure the frozen one is only available in there. But when you walk in either way, there's a cart right there, and it's usually fucking busy as hell. Don't stand there. Instead, go over to the Hogshead and stand in line at the bar. It's way smaller of a line because they don't know that they have it there. So hit those places and you'll have all your drinks much quicker.
Look, it's the Weasley's flying car. Headlights still on, half running, and beeping.
All right, so we rode Harry Potter, but I wasn't allowed to record on it. So now we are heading down to the lower lot. There's a few rides over there. There's only a few rides left, and then we'll be heading out of here. So, hey, Jake, hold up, dude. All right, let's go. We have to go down 1,000 escalators. Escalator 1. Escalator 2.
We got those. But good news, there's Jurassic Park.
Escalator 3. Insidious. I actually kind of pumped up about this movie. I want to see it soon. And Escalator 4. It's a smaller one. Next up, The Mummy.
1 second.
And because the police are saying that she wants compensation for having to take off work, you know, a third time they came out, you know,
they were just scared from this, like, air blast thing. There's like a magic cube. The Mummy ride here is based on kind of like, I guess it's based on the movie, but it puts you in the world of the movie, if that makes sense. In Florida, when you're in line and stuff, it has like a bunch of movie props and it talks about the movie in our world. So it's talking about like the backstage and stuff and all that stuff. It's over here.
Bathroom?
I don't know where the bathroom is, but the Haunted House is over here. Jacob's walking that way already. Anyway, so this ride was all about like the actual tomb and all that stuff. No mention of the movie at all. The ride was also not as long as the one in Florida. So, yeah. But we're about to head out, but there's a small wait over here. So we're going to hit the Walking Dead again. So I just, like I said, I'm not able to record inside. Laura keeps trying to stick her ring in every shot. I'm going to actually buy a pair of spy glasses so that I can record stuff and vlog it when I'm not supposed to. So that's gonna be cool. But anyway, so I will record as much as I can any stuff I didn't really record last time. And yeah, so.
Good night, Neverland.
All right, guys, that's it for us at Universal Studios Hollywood. We still got 2 days left of this California Hollywood trip. I've recorded that shit all day. I guess he should accept someone's window. Anyway, that's going to be it for us today. Thank you guys very much for watching. I am Justin Hill tuning out, and you stay scary.
Baby!